y'all see all this space right here?
Swabble, beautiful people. Bet swabble, bet swabble. Right. Trina, hey girl, hey. Bet swabble, bet swabble. What are y'all getting? Find my place, Job 28.
Okay. What is it? I don't
know.
Nothing in here.
Yeah. Okay. All right, beautiful people. Top of the day, top of the day. Betswabble, betswabble. It is Tuesday, September the 15th, 2020, day 253 of year two of reading through the books of the Law and the Prophets, also known as the Old Testament. We are on the two-year consecutive day count, day 616, without the Sabbaths added. If we added the Sabbaths in, that's a whole lot more days, and we will probably be in the 700 count, the 700 day count. Because 1 year, there's 52 Sabbaths. So, yeah, 52 for the first year. And almost 52 for the second year. That's 100-something right there. And that's not even counting the Sabbath days that come with the feast days. All right? Okay. So, today we are reading Job 28, 29.
What?
What
you looking like
that,
homeboy? What?
The sun's not even... Oh, yeah. Oh, boy, you scared me with that look. I thought something... Mm. Okay, they out here. They sun gazing, y'all. They're looking at the sun. It's rising. It's orange. It'll be up in a second. Right? And then you can see it through the trees. It's big and orange.
That's crazy.
Okay. All right, y'all. So today, Job, let me go ahead and read it. Job speaks of wisdom. Job speaks of wisdom and understanding. Job 28. People know where to mine silver and how to refine gold. They know where to dig iron from the earth and how to smelt copper from the rock. They know how to shine light in darkness and explore the farthest regions of the earth as they search in the dark for one. I'm sorry. Or as they search in the dark for. Oh, I think I found a typo here. It says, hold on. They know how to shine light in the darkness and explore the farthest regions of the earth as they search in the dark for ore. As they search in the dark for ore, should there be more? Hold on, y'all. Let me just change something real quick. That just threw me off. I want to know if that's a typo or if that's really what they're saying right there. I'm sorry, hold on. Let me go to a different version. Let me go to the KJV real quick. As they search in the dark for... Verse 3. He setteth an end to darkness and searcheth out all perfection, the stones of darkness and the shadow of death. That doesn't help me at all. Okay. Alright, y'all. I think that may say as they search in the dark for ore, for more. Alright, I'm sorry. Let me go back. Okay, I just read again. They know how to shine light in the darkness and explore the farthest regions of the earth as they search in the dark for ore. They sink a mine shaft into the earth far from where anyone lives. They descend on ropes swinging back and forth. Food is grown on the earth above, but down below, the earth is melted as by fire. Here, the rocks contain precious lapis lazuli. You know, the color of lapis lazuli is almost, this is like a bright, shining, like electrical blue lapis lazuli. Here, the rocks contain precious lapis lazuli, and the dust contains gold. These are treasures no bird of prey can see, no falcon's eyes observe. No wild animal has walked upon these treasures. No lion has ever set his paw there. People know how to tear apart flinty rocks and overturn the roots of mountains. They cut tunnels in the rocks and uncover precious stones. They dam up the trickling streams and bring to light the hidden treasures. But do people know where to find wisdom? But do people know where to find wisdom? Where can they find understanding? No one knows where to find it, for it is not found among the living. It is not here, says the ocean, nor is it here, says the sea. It cannot be bought with gold. It cannot be purchased with silver. It is worth more than all the gold of Ophir, greater than the precious onyx or lapis lazuli. Wisdom is more valuable than gold and crystal. It cannot be purchased with jewels mounted in fine gold. Coral and jasper are worthless in trying to get it. The price of wisdom is far above rubies. What do we also hear this at? We also hear this in Proverbs chapter 31, where it's talking about wisdom. That's the go-to chapter for wisdom. A virtuous wife, so to speak, and her wisdom. But you get what I'm saying. Precious peridot from Ethiopia cannot be exchanged for it. It is worth more than the purest gold. But do people know where to find wisdom? Where they can find understanding? It is hidden from the eyes of all humanity. Even the sharp-eyed birds in the sky cannot discover it. Destruction and death say, we've heard only rumors of where wisdom can be found. Yah alone understands the way to wisdom. He knows where it can be found, for he looks throughout the whole earth and sees everything under the heavens. He decided how hard the wind should blow and how much rain should fall. He made the laws for the rain and laid out the path for the lightning. That puts a whole nother perspective on all this rain and stuff people are getting in certain places. I mean, we all know that Yah's in control of everything, whether people can see it directly or indirectly. I'm going to read that again, because some people are getting like nonstop rain, flooding, and everything. That is the decision of Yah. Let me read that again. Yah alone understands the way to wisdom. He knows where it can be found, for he looks throughout the whole earth and sees everything under the heavens. He decided how hard the winds should blow and how much rain should fall. He made the laws for the rain and laid out a path for the lightning. Then he saw wisdom and evaluated it. He set it in place and examined it thoroughly. And this is what he says to all humanity. The fear of Yahuwah is true wisdom. To forsake evil is real understanding. And we know also we read about that in Psalms. In Proverbs as well. All right, Job chapter 29. Hey, Yosh. Job speaks of his former blessings. Job continues speaking. I long for the years going by when Yah took care of me, when he lit up the way before me, and I walked safely through the darkness. When I was in my prime, Yah's friendship was felt in my home. The Almighty was still with me, and my children were around me. My steps were awash in cream, and the rocks gushed olive oil for me. Those were the days when I went to the city gate and took my place among the honored leaders. The young stepped aside when they saw me, and even the aged rose in respect at my coming. The prince stood in silence and put their hands over their mouths. The highest officials of the city stood quietly, holding their tongues in respect. All who heard me praised me. All who saw me spoke well of me, for I assisted the poor in their need and the orphans who required help. I helped those without hope, and they blessed me. And I caused the widows' hearts to sing for joy. Everything I did was honest. Righteousness covered me like a robe, and I wore justice like a turban. I served as eyes for the blind and feet for the lame. I was a father to the poor and assisted strangers who needed help. I broke the jaws of godless oppressors and plucked their victims from their teeth. I thought surely I would die surrounded by my family after a long good life. For I am like a tree whose roots reach the water, whose branches are refreshed with the dew. New honors are constantly bestowed on me, and my strength is continually renewed. Everyone listened to my advice. They were silent as they waited for me to speak. And after I spoke, they had nothing to add, for my counsel satisfied them. They longed for me to speak as people long for rain. They drank my words like a refreshing spring rain. When they were discouraged, I smiled at them. My look of approval was precious to them. Like a chief, I told them what to do. I lived like a king among his troops and comforted those who mourned. Last chapter for today, y'all. Job chapter 30. Job speaks of his anguish. But now I am mocked by people younger than I, by young men whose fathers are not worthy to run with my sheepdogs. Bruh, that, I'm going to have to use that one day. Okay. But now I am mocked by people younger than I, by young men whose fathers are not worthy to run with my sheepdogs. A lot of good they are to me, those worn out wretches. They are gaunt from poverty or hunger. They claw the dry ground and desolate wastelands. They pluck wild greens from among the bushes and eat from the roots of broom trees. They are driven from human society, and people shout at them as if they were thieves. So now they live in frightening ravines, in caves among the rocks. They sound like animals howling among the bushes, huddled together beneath the nettles. They are nameless fools, outcasts from society, and now they mock me with vulgar songs. They taunt me, they despise me, and won't come near me except to spit in my face. For Yah has cut my bowstring, he has humbled me, so they have thrown off all restraint. These outcasts oppose me to my face. They send me sprawling and lay traps in my path. They block my road and do everything they can do to destroy me. They know I have no one to help me. They come at me from all directions. They jump on me when I am down. I live in terror now. My honor has blown away in a wind, and my prosperity has vanished like a cloud. And now my life seeps away. Depression haunts my days. At night, my bones are filled with pain, which gnaws at me relentlessly. With a strong hand, Yah grabs my shirt. He grips me by the collar of my coat. He has thrown me into the mud. I am nothing more than dust and ashes. I cry to you, O Yah, but you do not answer. I stand before you, but you don't even look. You have become cruel toward me. You use your power to persecute me. You throw me into the whirlwind and destroy me in the storm. And I know you are sending me to my death, the destination of all who live. Surely, no one would turn against the needy when they cry for help in their trouble. Did I not weep for those in trouble? Was I not deeply grieved for the needy? So I looked for good, but evil came instead. I waited for the light, but darkness fell. My heart is troubled and relentless. Days of suffering torment me. I walk in gloom without sunlight. I stand in the public square and cry for help. Instead, I am considered a brother to jackals and a companion to owls. My skin has turned dark and my bones burn with fever. My harp plays sad music and my flute accompanies those who weep. And that, my beautiful people, is our reading for today. That was Job 28, 29, and 30. It is Tuesday, September the 15th, 2020, day 253. All right, y'all, we're heading to the book of Numbers to do the blessing that Yah commanded to be put on his people. All right, so y'all know the verses 22 through 27. And Yahuwah spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto Aaron and unto his son, saying, on this wise you shall bless the children of Israel, saying unto them, may Yahuwah bless us and keep us. May Yahuwah make his face to shine upon us and be gracious unto us. May Yahuwah lift up his countenance upon us and give us his peace. And they shall put my name upon the children of Israel, and I will bless them. Whose name? Yah's name. And who's going to bless us? Yah himself will bless us. All right, beautiful people, I love you, and I will see you Thursday morning. Remember, this Friday we're coming up on a new moon, which starts over the new moon cycle. This Friday is also the Feast of Trumpets. It's the Feast of Trumpets. This is the only new moon that is considered a Sabbath. There is festivals held on each new moon, but this particular moon, the new moon in the seventh month according to Yahuwah's calendar, the beginning of the seventh month, is the Feast of Trumpets. And we literally, to commemorate that, we actually blow trumpets. People blow shofars. Some people may not have a trumpet, but some people, they like lift up a loud voice, but it says to blow the trumpet. So if you ain't got a trumpet, go get you a trumpet or something and blow it on that day. All right. Just to be obedient to the law, you know. So, and we know that the Sabbath day account begins over. So now, like I said, this is the month where everybody will be lining up celebrating the Sabbath on the same day. Because currently, most people, I'm not going to say all people because all people don't. Some people actually follow and getting back on the right track according to how Enoch laid everything out in the calendar, the 364-day calendar and everything, which causes it. It's a lot easier to follow, and it lines up with nature, and everybody can see. You can't be tricked by it, and if you get off track, you're able to get back on track every month when we got a new moon or a full moon, because we always know that the full moon falls on the 15th day of the month according to the book of Enoch and how Yahuwah set out nature, you know, all that good stuff. So now we'll be celebrating the Sabbath on Friday for this new moon cycle, and also for those who do it actually this month, this new moon cycle for September to October and October to November. The September to October new moon cycle Sabbaths fall on Friday, and then October, September to October, October to November, the October to November new moon cycle, the next new moon will be in October on a Saturday. So it will switch all the Sabbaths to the Saturday. Remember, the Sabbaths line up with the new moon day. Whatever day the new moon is on, the Sabbaths line up with that day. So if it falls on a Thursday, if the new moon falls on a Thursday, the Sabbaths will line up, because the count begins over every new moon cycle. The Sabbaths will line up with the day of the new moon. That's how we can easily get back on track. Yahuwah doesn't make anything hard for us. Anybody at any given point in time in history, if you get off track, there's an easy way to get back on track and fall in line. But, you know, everybody, they kind of go with what the Jewish people tell you. And I can't believe everything everybody tell me anymore. That's why I've been doing my own study. Got to go in and look at it for myself, because they lie to us about a lot of things. Why do you think they won't lie to us about that, right? They have. All right, so with that being said, I love you beautiful people. See you bright and early Thursday. Yep, 'cause tomorrow we rest. Bruce.